But 13, 12, 11, 9. The last thing you need is people like label, like demanding that you choose what your label is and take like drastic steps accordingly. I think that's just bad. That's bad for any thing. It's like you are a, I think parents who do it to their kids, well, this is my own bias too. Religion is sort of like this, where it's like you are this and your identity will be this, and to stray from it is to be a disappointment to everyone around you. It's just like so hard to shoulder for kids who that doesn't apply to.
Yeah.
You know, so it's like if you're not feeling the religion, I grew up super strict or super like Mormon religion, conservative sort of insular thing. But if you don't fit the mold, it's super stressful and you're just like lying to yourself the whole time. And it looks to me like it's, if you're awkward about your body and don't know, and you just feel awkward about yourself and you're being told you are trans or you are whatever, and you need to like adopt that whole set of everything that goes with that at that young age, I think that's a mistake, a total mistake. And people should know better too. The adults who are trans, the adults who are religious, the adults who are any of these identities that they have carved for themselves should know better than to try and force young people into those same things, is my thinking.
Yeah.
They'll get there if they're going to get there, or not if they don't, but to try and force it, I think, is damaging. Anyway,
it's basically grooming on some sort of level. I mean, like,
yeah, and like,
there are, like you said, like, there are, like, very, there was a generation of, or I think it was, like, around any timeline, they had their tomboy kind of phase, and then they grew out of it and just became, like, a regular woman or something like that. And then I'm guessing that this, my teacher's niece, she could have been a tomboy at the time, but then she got groomed by something, I guess, like the internet or so.
Or peer groups,
friends, or the internet, or they're all saying that, oh yeah, if you are a thing like that, you must be trans. Like, no, it's just the tomboy phase. It's,
yeah. Well, my thing too is if my daughter ends up being like, I think I'm a boy and I want to present as a boy, and all that stuff, I'm, cut your hair, wear different clothes, do everything you want. Chemicals, absolutely. Surgery, nope. Hormones, get it out of here. Any of that stuff that's going to disrupt your natural body progression, I think is a mistake at a young age. I just do. I don't think kids that age are mature enough. They're not mature enough to decide whether, we don't let them drink alcohol, which has a detrimental effect to their development. Mm-hmm. Right? Certainly. So why are we letting them, you know, not, or why are we letting them make decisions like that? I think that a measured response is better.
Yeah. It's like, it's like I said, it's just all this grooming, like, ideologies. You're just pushing forward with all these crazy things that nobody really wants to be, you know? I
don't know. I think there are some, like, again, for an adult, like, once you've reached the point where you can make solid decisions for yourself, it's like similar, I just keep thinking of like drinking or any like things that have impacts on your physiology. When you're old, when you're a certain amount of developed or matured, those decisions start to become more salient for you to make as an adult person in charge of your situation.
Yeah.
For a young kid, it's like, we don't let them jump behind the wheel of a car. We don't let them drink. There's a lot of these restrictions we place on them to allow them to mature through stages in a safe and less impactful manner. And I don't see why we wouldn't continue that idea across the board, if that makes sense.
Exactly. It's like, for me, I think it was just like, it feels like another form of like abuse on kids, you know? That's what I'm thinking about.
It's tough because it comes from, I think, like a lot of things, it comes from a place of really wanting to like validate and support kids, because, you know, the history of humankind has been kids sit on the floor, no one wants to hear you or see you, kind of a thing. And it's like, that's not great either. Luckily, we've sort of made our way out of that for the most part. But it's like, how far do you go from that before you're supporting kids? And I've had there's people I knew who homeschooled their kids, and they did it in the way where it's like, what do you want to learn about today? Dragons. Okay, today we're studying about dragons. And it's just like no structure, no imposition. I don't want to make the child uncomfortable. I don't want to make them whatever. And so they get to dictate the entirety of the everything. And I think that is swung too far the other direction, you know. Like somewhere there must be a happy medium where you'd be like, here's some structure. I support you and value you and everything, but here's some constraints and structures that you can grow inside of.
Yeah. And don't mind the camera thing.
Yeah, what are you recording me?
I'm recording, as in, this is like, you know, pretty much like Jordan Peterson, like a local Jordan Peterson.
If you post it online, you'll never be allowed in my office hours again. That's not
this true. This is like, I'm not saying that you should be attacked like Jordan Peterson, but Jordan Peterson is more respected than attacked, so that's why a lot of people like him so much.
It's definitely a polarizing figure because, you know, stands his ground on things that he thinks are right.
Yeah. He has, like, a lot of good morals, and a lot of people should, like, take some more info about him. I remember, like, my old math teacher, he was, like, talking to me about, like, if you have these kind of problems, you should probably look up to, like, Jordan Peterson. And I did write him down, and, like, the more and more I kind of grew up a little bit, like, trying to, like, understand how mentality things work, I've been seeing a lot more Jordan Peterson videos. Like,
was that the first you've been introduced to?
Yeah, he was like talking to me about like, Jordan Peterson, and then like next thing you know, the more I kind of like grew up with like these kind of videos and such, like the like suggestions of Jordan Peterson videos on YouTube was like popping up more and more. And I was like,
as you watch them,
yeah, like, yeah, it actually all makes sense, I guess.
Yeah, I know he's helped a ton of people get their sort of. For people who need to hear the message, hey, get your stuff together and quit screwing around, which I think quite a lot of people benefit from that message. I certainly relate to that message. It's really helped, from what I can see, it's helped a lot of people sort of get their lives in order, despite being, you know, railed against as some terrible person. I've watched a lot of his videos. I've watched a lot of people talking about his videos, both positive and negative, and I don't know. I watched his videos before he got big, like his class lectures. Those were what I was really interested in, like the psychology of just sort of like the psychological lectures that he had posted. Mm-hmm. And then he blew up after that. What was it? I can't remember which school he was at, but
it was somewhere in Canada. That's for sure.
Yeah, and was it a Canadian school with the video I was watching? Maybe so. That's where he teaches. That's where his school is that he taught at. But anyway, I think that there's a lot of good messaging that he has. I disagree with him on some things, particularly obviously in the religion realm. I think he gives religion a pass that I wouldn't give, but I get where he's coming from, where it's like the story is the important thing, and there's something about humans' need to tell stories to each other and have that be valued that is not worth ignoring, which is true enough, fair enough, that I can't follow along on this supernatural trip so well.
I think supernatural, if you're like non-believer thing, the supernatural kind of things are just fun for fantasy.
Yeah.
Kind of escapism kind of stuff, that's why a lot of people enjoy Lord of the Rings, you know?
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Included.
It doesn't matter if you're, like, religious or atheist or all that stuff.
Yeah, elves and hobbits aren't real, but the story is important. Yeah. The story is, yeah. That's
what makes everything fun. You know?
Yeah.
The kisses of the sun were sweet, I didn't blink, I let it in my eyes. Like an exotic dream, the radio playing songs that I have never heard, I don't know what to say. Oh, not another word, just la 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 la. It goes around the world, just la 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 la. It's all around the world, just la 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 la. And everybody's singing la 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 la. And now that pleasure.